Hi guys, and welcome back to this video. I am super excited to announce, and you can probably tell by the title, that I am pregnant. I am pregnant with baby number two. I am due end of April, and I'm currently 9 weeks, so still early in the first trimester. You probably maybe have noticed that I haven't been posting a ton of stuff on my Instagram or on my YouTube channel because honestly, I've been feeling so crappy. I've been way sicker with this pregnancy than I was with my daughter. With my daughter, I had nausea and vomiting, but this pregnancy is like a step up. I'm constantly nauseous. I'm vomiting every single day, mostly several times a day. And so it's been a huge struggle. So I kind of want to just talk a little bit about how it's been working as a nurse in my first trimester, and more in particular, working in a COVID unit while I'm pregnant, because I know that that's kind of a controversy, and just, you know, there's limited information out there, and I want to kind of talk about why I am choosing to still work in a COVID unit. So, let's just start with how I'm feeling. Like I said, super nauseous, vomiting. I'm having a very, very hard time functioning on my days off, let alone at work. I actually had my OB prescribe me some anti-nausea medicines because it's just really hard to like function, especially since I have an almost 2-year-old at home and I'm chasing her around. And so it's been hard at work. I actually have not thrown up at work. And I think that's just because when you're at work and you're distracted and you're in a like not a comfortable environment, you really like do everything you can to like not puke at work. I really just like don't want to puke at work. So usually right when I get home is when I'm throwing up, but it's been hard. I'm really hoping that after my first trimester, I start to feel better. I did with my last pregnancy. So, we'll see. But I'm also still working in my COVID ICU. I decided to not like transition to either another ICU that's non-COVID or change jobs or anything like that. And I kind of want to give you guys my rationale. So being in a COVID ICU, I am wearing the full COVID precautions with every patient interaction. So whether you're positive COVID or you're rule out COVID, I'm wearing, you know, my respirator, my goggles and masks and gown and gloves and everything. And I'm just extra cautious with my interactions with these COVID patients. And I chose that over switching to another unit because I feel like it's better for me, and this is just my personal thoughts and opinions, it's better for me to stay in the COVID unit and know what I'm being exposed to, or like in wearing all the protective gear, than it is for me to work in another ICU, be wearing, you know, just a surgical mask or goggles or whatever, and then them say, oh, this patient that you've been taking care of the last 3 days, we're going to rule them out for COVID. And I'm like, great, now my exposure is higher because I wasn't wearing all this protective gear. And now I've been more exposed there than I would have if I was just wearing all this protective gear in the ICU, the COVID ICU. So that's kind of my thoughts. I know that there's just still not a whole lot of information as far as moms getting COVID and the, you know, babies getting COVID, and we're still learning, you know, the effects of if you get COVID in your first trimester versus your third or whatnot. But as far as I know, I have not had COVID. My antibody test was negative a couple months ago, but I haven't had any symptoms of anything COVID related. And so my guess is I've probably not had it. So I still have the potential to get it, but I'm just being, yeah, as careful as I can. I'm not really taking any extra precautions other than just being super diligent with taking my scrubs off, right? You know, when I get home, my shoes stay in the garage, washing hands, wiping my keys and steering wheel, and all those things that I've talked about, I've been doing and I still plan to do, even now that I'm pregnant. My work does know that I'm pregnant. I told them right away once I found out, and that way they just know, like, that I'm pregnant, and they can try to assign me, you know, patients that are appropriate or whatnot, especially when you get further along, you're like, don't want these like really heavy assignments necessarily. And so they've been super awesome, understanding. If you guys want to see like more pregnancy nursing videos, I've done a couple on this channel when I went through my first and second and third trimester with my daughter. So you can go check those out. I'll link them all like in the description. description box. But other than that, besides feeling just really crappy, I'm doing okay. The baby's healthy. I'm healthy other than just exhausted and nauseous all the time. And I hope if maybe you're pregnant and you're worried about, you know, working as a nurse, that this kind of eases your mind a little bit, in the sense that like there's a lot of us that are still working in COVID units. My OB actually said that most of his pregnant nurses have decided to do the same thing and have chosen to continue working in COVID units, because it's the evil you know versus the evil you don't know. And I would rather just be protected and exposed to COVID patients than to be not as protected and exposed to COVID patients. And that's just how I look at it. So I will link all those pregnancy videos that I've done from my last pregnancy down below. If you want to like watch more of like my pregnancy announcement, symptom updates, all that, I will link my other channels down below. I have a vlog channel and then I have like a personal channel, and you'll be able to see all my personal stuff on there. You can also follow me on my personal Instagram, which I have linked down below as well. So lots of links, and I will see you guys in my next video.